Disaster, craze, it's a trap, totally uncontrollable and unexplainable. Not surprisingly, we use falling in love to describe the chaos we experience after unexpectedly getting this feeling, the best feeling in the world. No matter how mysterious it appears to us, we should admit that the scientists have made several groundbreaking discoveries to show us why it happens and what actually happens. Dear guest of this channel, don't forget to subscribe and welcome to your own brain. Throughout decades, scholars and philosophers have been postulating about love being a chemical reaction. In the 1980s, however, the science of love picked up the steam, and today we have pretty much a lot to share in topic. Helen Fisher, Doctor of Philosophy from Rutgers University and a leading researcher on love, attraction and romance, explains the biology of love and how we actually develop the attraction. Fisher says love includes three basic brain circuits: sex drive, romantic love, and attachment phase. There is the sex drive, which motivates us to seek out partners. And it's simply the craving for gratification, driven by testosterone in men and women. Romantic love, the most powerful out of the three systems, is responsible for all the butterflies in your stomach. Scientists examined the brains of the people in love and noticed activation in the same area as when you expect to receive a large reward. And it's the same area which lights up in cocaine users who anticipate using drugs. The attachment phase, the comfortable but fewer fireworks stage, speaks for itself. It involves serious social, cultural, and psychological grounds for the two to stay together. Let's now get into detail of how we read the potential partner's profile and what we consider appealing in it. Odor. Unique body smells are heavily influenced by MHC, major histocompatibility complex, which is, to put it simple, a set of genes. Numerous studies provide evidence showing MHC influences mate preference. In one famous sweaty t-shirt study conducted in 1995, men wore the same t-shirt for 2 days. Women were asked to smell the shirts of different men. Turned out, they were attracted more to men with an MHC most dissimilar from their own. In a 2005 study, participants of different orientations and genders were asked to choose between odors of straight men, gay men, straight women, and lesbian women. Each picked the odor of a partner of the preferred gender and orientation, and some more chemistry. To explain it to the mere mortals, scientists call oxytocin the love hormone, as the levels of oxytocin increase during hugging and orgasm.
Oh, yes, yes, yes!
It is also associated with empathy, trust, and relationship building. Another confirmation of the active chemical reaction happening between the two is the phenomenon called love at first sight. In the late 1900s, American market researcher Earl Naumann interviewed 1,495 people across the USA about love at first sight. According to Naumann, we get to know the environment through our senses of sight, smell, and touch, and all these contributes to triggering the chemical reaction of love. 2/3 of the questioned people said they believe in love at first sight. 55% experienced it. And half of those who experienced it even married the object of their affection. Interestingly, even before people fall in love, seeing an attractive face activates the same part of the brain as do painkillers, such as morphine. A recent study showed that men who were given small doses of morphine rated photographs of women's faces as more attractive than did men who didn't take any morphine. It means that the opioid system can be primed to perceive attractiveness. So, in the end of the day, it evidently takes something more than just chemistry to convert your chemical love into the love of your life. And here at We Know How, we really hope you will find your perfect partner. Stay tuned and subscribe to our channel for other incredible insights.